John. So just first of all, just introduce us a little bit to the story of Annabelle.
Okay, it's really just about a mother who is protecting her daughter, little daughter, from a doll that's possessed by a demon, in a nutshell.
Obviously, it's a prequel to The Conjuring. It is the story of Annabelle before mm-hmm. we meet her in The Conjuring.
Right.
In what way did you want to sort of try and keep the connections with The Conjuring going beyond Annabelle?
Well, you know, we opened the movie, actually, with similar shots from the same scene that's in the opening of The Conjuring. So we set the tone immediately that, you know, that we, so the audience knows where it ended up. And that gives us the license to then tell the audience kind of how it got there.
Obviously, with this being an origin story for the doll and its say, demonic mm-hmm. spirit, did you do anything to the actual Annabelle doll to sort of change it, to have it, to sort of have her before she is possessed and then after, and to see
yes.
how she progresses?
Truly I did, yeah. Mm-hmm. She starts out pristine and very clean and porcelain skin and eyes that are less creepy, and then, you know, once she, you know, the metaphorically she becomes possessed, slowly through the script or through the story, we age her face, we dirty her dress, we change her eyes. It's most of it's done in her eyes and a little bit in her wig, and we had like four sets of eyes for her basically, and so yeah, we truly gave her a character arc as well.
Obviously, beyond Annabelle herself, a lot of the focus is on Ward and Annabelle, the actress,
sure.
as Mia and John.
Sure.
How did you go about sort of finding those two? And was it important to find some people that could be the pair as well as, you know, their own?
Absolutely. And it was interesting how it happened because we found Annabelle Wallace in the UK. And she has a great American accent. And she just, the first time I saw her, I felt she was our Mia. And it didn't take long to convince everybody else of that, even though there was a bit of a problem with the visa potentially, so we had to leave her for a bit, and thank God we ended up coming back to her. So it was very much serendipity. Then as for getting Ward, yeah, we totally needed to find someone that would be, you know, congruous with her as a, you know, as her husband in a real way. This has to be very real. And, you know, it's interesting, Annabelle read with four actors, Ward being one. And he came in so prepared and so in his Brooks Brothers with his looking like a doctor of the time. I mean, such a pro. And you could tell immediately the chemistry between them as husband and wife in that era. It just happened.
Obviously, James directed The Conjuring and you
yeah.
were a cinematographer on that. Mm-hmm. How then did you collaborate as producer and director this time?
It was, you know, it was more from story. His input mainly was from story. It wasn't necessarily technique on how to pull it off, even though James did come in on one weekend and we worked together to do a couple of the jump scares together, kind of working together like old times, which was really cool. But basically is from story suggestions and that. And then he gave me the baton and pretty much let me do it.
What scares you in real life?
What scares me in real life? Myself in the mirror. No. I don't know. I don't get really scared that much. I guess what scares me the most maybe is the anticipation of pushing myself beyond something that I'm not sure I can do. And I think that's true even in horror movies, maybe with, you know, people they don't want to, but they want to face their demons. You know what I mean?
What was the most sort of technically, logistically challenging part of the film to do? Because obviously you do a lot of it practically as opposed to having lots of green screen or little CGI
sure.
creatures.
Challenging, you know, really the biggest challenge I want to say to a degree was time, only because, it was a much smaller budget and we only had so much time to do it. So it was a matter of being able to do really good work in the time allotted. I think, and we did it, but it took a lot of planning, which I believe in anyway. But that was definitely a challenge, and you know, it worked. Because sometimes, you know, necessity is the mother of invention, as we know, and I believe that's true in filmmaking as well.
Annabelle, only in cinemas.